Take two.
African queen, ooh lord, just like the sun lights up the earth, it lights up my life. The only one I ever see with a smile so bright. And just yesterday, you came around my way, you changed my horse in way. You're astonishing beauty. Oh, you could not make a brother sing. No ordinary thing, a supernatural being. And no, you are brighter than the moon, brighter than the star. I love you just the way you are. And you are my African queen, the girl of my dreams. You take me where I've never been, yeah. You make my heart go ding-a-ling-a-ling. Oh, you are my African queen, the girl of my dreams. And you remind me of a thing, and that is the African beauty. Hey, hey, yeah. Ooh, you are my African queen. Oh, Lord, oh, Lord. Out of a million, you stand as.
I'm
upon now. Behold, the bridegroom comes. When the bride has arrived, behold, the bridegroom comes.
I've got friends in the high places, so high, but not so far away. I've got friends in high places, and I'm gonna be with them. There's a father with his son, and the angels each and
The life and spirit, my brother Clinton,
in the life of his friend and my sister and daughter, listen to me. Together, I'll sing. Thank you now for your presence. And the next point in the service is where we celebrate what is known for many of us as the Eucharist, or as Holy Communion. We celebrate the sacrifice of Jesus Christ for the souls of all humankind. That is our belief here, and it is what we have lived with for years. At this table, all are welcome. At this table, all are welcome. Again, I want to say, at this table, all are welcome. It is your choice. You can decide not to, and we honor that. But all who work, we welcome you to this table. And bow your heads in the word of God. It is privilege to honor you, our Christ. The Holy Ghost, for your steady reminder that this is a part of our ultimate responsibility in recognizing the redemptive work of the man from Galilee. We thank you. Honor our effort to obey, bless these elements, and bless our lives in whatever way our prayer moves towards you. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Ghost. We thank you. You take bread, bless, take it, and this is my body. You take the cup, and say, this is my bread. Those of you who would celebrate with us, if you would take the center aisle and just come forward to receive the elements, we welcome you. And if you can hold on to them until you get back, we would like to do it almost as, I tell my people, almost as a dividing point. Take the center aisle, please, and you can move with us. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
represents the fact of incarnation. We say the second defect of our sins. The Word was made flesh and dwelt amongst us. God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish but have everlasting life. We break this bread and we eat together in the name of Jesus of Nazareth. He said, do this in remembrance of me. Let's eat together in Jesus. And we gather in the night for the moon. This cup, the symbol of the cup, this drink, the fruit of the gospel, is symbolic of the blood in multiple ways. But that night, on a Thursday evening, Alcott instituted another miracle. And he said, this is my body, this is my blood. Of the new covenant, do this in remembrance of me. For we are the Alcott. Let's go together to Jesus. At this time in our service, I always listen to how many lips are going to snap. And if any of you have been disappointed because it was not Welch's great juice, good. This is the start of the listening. You may be seated. There is a story of our Lord in the second chapter, and it goes like this. Reading from the King James version, we have other versions we know, but I'm 72, so I'm pretty familiar with the King James. And the third day goes the marriage in Cana of Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. And both Jesus was called and his disciples to the marriage. And when they wanted wine, the mother of Jesus said unto him, they had no wine. Jesus said unto her, woman, what have I to do with you? Thine hour is not yet come. His mother said unto the servant, whatsoever he saith unto you, do it. And there was set there three water pots of stone after the manner of the purifying of the Jews, containing two or three sprinklings of water. Jesus said unto them, fill the water pots with water. And they filled them up to the brim. And he said unto them, draw out now, and bear unto the governor of the feast. And they bear it. From the rule of the feast that tasted the water that was made wine, and knew not whence it was, but the servants which drew the water knew, the governor of the feast called the bridegroom, and said unto him, every man at the beginning does set forth good wine, and when men have well drunk, then that which is worse, the thou hast kept the good wine until now. This beginning of miracles did Jesus in Cana of Galilee and manifested forth his glory as his disciples believed on him. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Amen. At this time, the bride and groom have brought friends to want to give words of encouragement. One is Reverend Edwards, and then Dr. Edwards. Sir, would you please come forward? And I trust that there is a place here that you can speak and be heard. And following Reverend Edwards to the brother of Reverend Edwards. This is just brother. John. All right, Douglas Edwards, would you please come and be ready also? Douglas Howard. I'm sorry, Douglas Howard. Thank you. And get the most famous to do it. And can set out and understand and life together. These people come on behalf of my life to come and die. And you say that God will follow you with the necessary resources you will need to meet and overcome every challenge with which you will be encountered. The Reverend Courtney is a last of my life who all the way back to 1985 when he left Seminole in Jamaica and I entered. So over these 35 years, I've come to know him as a person with an extremely good heart. This heart is always open to others, often giving to them the benefit of the doubt, even when this might bring hurt and pain to himself. I also know him as an extremely generous person, generous in spirit, generous with time, generous with whatever possessions he has. That could be the strength from a person who experiences the deep things of God and the way that God is generous to us. But I want to make him as a self-sacrificing person. A person who literally will give the self on his back to facilitate the comfort of someone else. We have been praying together in the ministry within the field of psychotherapy. Always seeking the healing. The moving of God. So here is what I say. That you, Hotel and Mr. Tutu, that God will give you everything you need. So that this step you do today will be the first step. Thank you. and we'll respond to anything you come up against because we're facing together. Even when the ice is shallow, the life to me is perfect, it's tender, and it wraps around me, and I feel like there's a cocoon that protects us from the world. I've grown so much since we've been together, and I'm thankful that we focus both on our mutual growth as a couple and also as individuals. Always striving to be better, to be closer to God, to find our true selves, and to work out everything that we need to work out in this life so that God will be pleased with us. I feel blessed to have someone that I can be my whole entire self with. Including my faith in a child and every other part. And I'm able to be vulnerable. I appreciate the fact that we can be vulnerable with each other. And I'm standing here today because I said, God, my ancestors brought us together, and the strength of my love carries us. I will continue to carry us for the rest of our lives. I promise that I will love and support you as your wife and your queen for the rest of our lives and your elections are ready. I know we have a lifetime of joy and love ahead of us, and the journey we've taken so far in this family that our love is truly eternal, and with God we cannot lose. I promise to honor you, to be faithful, to be kind, to be patient, to hold you through good times and bad times, to hold you as you need us, as a family through life, assisted by the wisdom of your king. I love you so much more than words can say. I love the man that you are. You're compassionate, reflective, funny, loving, sensitive, God-loving, open-minded, strong, wise, and I'm just blessed to be here standing here today. I'm telling my love to thank everyone that we love. And I love you so much.
I knew that these latter days were going to be better than before. God proceeded to enter my life so that I could be filled with His gift, you. So from now on, I will live to make your mornings good, your afternoons better, but the evenings. Will be the best part of sharing my life with you. Because we will be filled with the glory of God. Every day I will bring home news that will make me leap for joy. Every prayer that I pray for you will be made so you can be filled with the blessings of the Lord. And overflow with a peace that surpasses understanding. I will honor you and love you in secret and in heart, and will forsake all others and be faithful to you as long as I live. This is my final.
I see that everybody reacted to the news. Out of the ones who turned of mine, you had 15 of them, brothers and sisters, 15 in the state of Tennessee, 15 of them. And he explained it differently. He said that whenever his daddy told his mama good night, he went. I'm not sure. His name has been called a couple of times. I'm not sure the doctor commonly has called the doctor to him. And he has so far. And we have four elements here that we use at this time. Just say a little bit about what man and life just might be. One of the things that we have here as elements is cayenne pepper. Because sometimes certain people get happy and they can get happy. If you're kidding, they can get happy. Sweet honey from the honeybee, because it can be sweet too. That's a clue. That's right. It's a clue. Together, as we put it at this point, hall, come this way. Yes, the room there. This is the unity tent. Because the light, the two, become one. You do not lose your individuality. Curtain problems. Curtain is still curtain. Necessity is still necessity. But something happened. When you talk about the epiphysis, where the bread and wine becomes the body and blood of Christ, it's called an epiphysis, a miracle. For there is a way to love. As long as you are ready with me.
Took place after the reception, in fact, y'all.
it was 7 days reception. Seven. Did you repeat with me 7 days? Have you ever been to a reception after it's been started half an hour? And you usually might have to step over somebody after half an hour. They've been drinking for what? 7 days. So when Jesus did get there, don't know. Guess what? The wine had run out. The wine had run out. This Mother Mary was there, and she had something to do with these implants, and knew these implants somehow. But she extended an invitation to Jesus to show up. Jesus showed up with the apostles. And I believe that when Jesus did show up after 7 days, he had to step over at least 4 to 5 to 6 to 7 people. And then he gets hit with the news by his Mother Mary. They have run out of wine. You've been drinking for 7 days. You ought to run out of wine. Jesus said to Mary, what do I have to do with that? I'm not certain of how to execute that portion of it, but I do remember that Luke said that when she got the announcement from the angel as to who her child would be, that it was so much that all she could do was plunder it in her heart. I believe certainly that some of what she was pondering in her heart over those years came out at that wedding. When she looked at the national ceremonies and said to the national ceremonies, whatever he tells you to do, do it. And that's exactly what she did. And the record says that Jesus told them to put some water in the water tank. We put water in the water pipe. And we believe, I have believed for a long time, that the water put in the water pipe was where the miracle took place. The wine in the water pipe turned into water in the water pipe, turned into water. And that's what I thought for a lot of years. And I was talking with a friend who started to explain to me the etymology of the word in the text. And the text word that says draw out, my friend shared with me that it did not mean draw out of the water pot. It meant draw out of the well. Now my text is on the right. I thought the water that was turned to wine was the water in the water pot. But no, according to the language, draw out meant draw out of the well. And it didn't make any sense to me until I remembered what caused the miracle in the first place. And what caused the miracle in the first place is they had a running out problem. They had a running out problem. They ran out of wine. And so they wanted more wine. And so to put water in the water pot, and then try and get to wine, guess what they were going to do? They were going to run out of wine again. Jesus said, let me put a halt to this right now. And he turned the water into well to wine, so that the joy of love and life and family would never be lost. Your joy is on schedule to be eternal. But morning, noon, and night. Oh, excuse me a minute. Mario Richie is coming in. All night long. All night long. My brother, my sister, I'm so grateful that you are with everybody. I'm so grateful that we were able to walk together as we have walked on this occasion. All right? And the next time we do a wedding like this, it'll be my first time on this call. I've already thanked you. The next time, that left the job, y'all won't be in this time. It is the renewal of God. The next time we have care for you. All right, and that'll go a little bit better. All right, but by the power invested in me, by the laws of New York State, Can you understand for the Lord? The eastern coast of the United States. Brooklyn. And Bethesda. I now pronounce you lawfully wedded, husband and wife, wedding to King tonight. You may salute your breath. All right, where is it? Where is it? It's out front. All right. Can we walk together just down here? This is a wonderful African culture. Things that they wanted to do, and I love it every time somebody does it. I now introduce to all of you, Mr. and Mrs. Clinton Robertini Lashley. Thank you.
I'll remember you were meant to be. sure it's you, yeah. Oh, baby, I know in my heart it's you. That's why I'm gonna say I'm